Hello my friends, today I would like to show you how to cook very famous Uzbek pilaf. The main ingredient of course is the meat. We are going to use chuck roast and short ribs. We need 1 kilo of rice. This is special rice, it's a long grain and they call it lazar. I tried to find it in English, but I can't. So if you go any Uzbek store, which is located in Brooklyn, for example, or maybe others, they call it lazar. Then we need 1.2 kilo of carrot. So usually in Uzbekistan, they use yellow carrot, but unfortunately, in US, we don't have yellow carrot, so we are going to use whatever is available. But if you can find yellow carrot, it's actually even better because the texture is better than orange one and the taste is better. We need one onion. For better taste, we're going to put 2 heads of garlic. Then we need vegetable oil. This is 200 milligram. Then we have 100 milligram of zagir oil, and then we have a special ingredient. This is actually fat, but we are going to heat it and dissolve the oil from the. This is actually going to be really good taste. And usually in Uzbekistan, they always use that fat. Then we need, they call it nut, but here in US, this is chickpeas, and you can find it in any store like Walmart, Kroger, or whatever you have available next to you. Then for the seasoning, we are going to put, this is barbaries. We call this barbaries in Russian. I don't know exactly what it called in English. Then we have cumin. This is also, I actually visited Uzbekistan this year and I brought Iranian cumin, which is very flavorful and very, it smells very good. So we're gonna use this one. Then of course we need a little bit black pepper and the salt. First off, we need to heat up the kazan. So set the heat to high medium and let it heat up for 5-10 minutes. Oil is the main ingredient to make pilaf tasty and cook it correctly. As you can see, I used lamb fat. In my opinion, pilaf tastes better if it's prepared with lamb fat. However, if you don't want to use it, you can use more vegetable oil. 500 milligrams of oil should be enough for 1 kilogram of rice. I cut the fat into 1/2 inch size and let it melt for 5-10 minutes. When the fat melted, I took out everything that had not melted. Then I added poplar cooking oil and heat it up for another 5-10 minutes. After that, I added vegetable oil and let it heat up for 5 minutes until a bit of smoke appeared. Then I added 1/2 onion to absorb the oil's unpleasant taste and odors. When I see brown spots on the onion, I take it out. Now is the time to cook meat. Be careful and do not drop everything at one time. Place meat piece by piece into the oil. First, I place it large pieces and let them fry a little. Then I place it small parts. Be careful, oil is very hot. I fried the meat until I started seeing a brown crust around it. Then I added chopped onion in the 1/2 rings. I fried everything together until the onion became a little clear and color. It took around 10-15 minutes. Then I added 1 tablespoon of sea salt, 1 teaspoon of black pepper, and 1 teaspoon of cumin. I stir everything periodically to make sure nothing burns. Let it fry for another 5 minutes. Add enough water to cover everything and cook until it starts boiling. After boiling for 5 minutes, I set the heat to medium and added the carrot. 1 tablespoon of sea salt and 1 teaspoon of cumin. Then I covered everything and let it cook it for 10-15 minutes. In the meantime, I started preparing rice. First, I washed the rice thoroughly with cold water. Then I add 1 tablespoon of sea salt and 1 tablespoon of turmeric to make the rice a little yellow. After all, I cover the rice with warm water and mix everything to ensure the turmeric dissolves properly. It's just for dish presentation to give the rice a more yellowish color. Turmeric is also useful for your health. Let it sit for 30 minutes, then wash it with fresh water. As you can see, rice becomes a little yellow and looks delicious. Let's return to my cousin and see what is going on under the cover. Trust me, it already smells good. I do not stir anymore because I don't want the carrot to start breaking apart. So I set my heat to low. Now we will add garlic, barberries, golden raisins and chickpeas. Also, I add 1 teaspoon of sea salt and 1 teaspoon of cumin and cover everything again for another 25-30 minutes. Now we are ready for the final step, cooking the rice. Before adding the rice, I set the heat to medium-high and added water. Add water as much as you need to cover everything with it. Wait until it starts to boil, then add rice. Distribute rice evenly and do not cover. Add 1 more tablespoon of sea salt and 1 teaspoon of cumin. And wait until water evaporates. To check if the water disappeared, pour rice with a chopstick or something else, it doesn't matter. You just need to check if water is left under the rice. It will take approximately 10 to 15 minutes for the water to evaporate. After that, only rice needs to be mixed for the first time. This procedure is to make sure the rice cooks evenly. After mixing everything, I add 1 teaspoon of sea salt and 1 teaspoon of cumin. I cover everything for another 15 minutes. Then I remove the cover and mix it again, adding another teaspoon of sea salt and 1 teaspoon of cumin. Then cover again for 15 minutes. After this step, set the heat to low. While pilaf is getting ready, you can make a side dish, salad, usually goes with the pilaf in Uzbekistan. It's called achichuk, made from tomato, cucumber, onion, salt and pepper. Chop it and mix it together. Our pilaf is ready. Remove cover, mix rice again and take everything from kazan to a large mixing bowl. Now you need to shred the meat and serve pilaf. And time to taste pilaf.
Okay, my friends, let's try. The rice is firm, cooked properly. Meat is good.
Okay, my friends, today actually is the special event because of the Christmas Eve, and I forgot a very important ingredient, which I'm going to fix it and put it. So, this is for celebration of Christmas, and of course I wish everyone Merry Christmas and Happy Holidays. Please subscribe, press like or dislike, and let's go!